When it comes to the performance of your off-road car or truck, one of the biggest things that affects your handling is going to be your shocks on both the front and the rear of your vehicle. We're here today with the Team Losi Racing 22T, the 22, and we'll give you some shots here of the 22 SCT in a few moments. We're going to talk about the shock packages on them because we're actually going through and we're building the shocks for the 22 SCT, which has as a stock feature a really neat upgrade for your 22T and for your 22. Out of the box, both of these vehicles, the 22 and the 22T, come with this style of shock cap. It's a solid cap that utilizes, I'm going to move the 22T out of the way here, both of these vehicles utilize out of the box these little rubber seals here. They're called bladders. And basically what happens is the bladder sits on the top of the shock, and as your piston moves up and down, your display shock oil pushes against this bladder. Let me show you here exactly how it would go in a shock. This is one of the front shocks actually off of the 22 SCT. So what I would normally do is I would fill up my shock here, I would place the bladder on here, and I would hold down on the top of the bladder, run the piston up, and oil would come out from around the bottom of the bladder. When I'm done, I would put the cap on. The problem with this is this rubber material of the bladder is essentially an uncontrolled spring. You have no way to change the rate of this. Depending on which bladder you use, front or rear, you may have different dampening. And quite honestly, it's just not quite as easy to bleed. Now, one of the solutions that we've had for a little bit of time, almost a year now, has been with the 22 ready to run and the 22T ready to run. They came with these shock caps here. It's a plastic shock cap that has a screw on the side that you can go ahead and bleed out excess oil. The other thing that we've been doing is we've actually been taking our bladders and cutting the center diaphragm type material out of it. Well, Team Losi Racing has made that a whole lot easier now, and we're going to show you how. First of all, the aluminum shock caps are really nice, and well, going to the plastic shock cap does give us the advantage of having that bleeder screw in there. The aluminum is just nicer. Now, Team Losi Racing has developed, and again, it's standard on the 22 SCT, option parts for any of the 22s or 22Ts, race or ready to run, is they have these bleeder caps that have this little hole here, and they also include these refined seals that go between the shock cap and the body to get you a better seal. So we're going to take a few moments right now, show you how to go ahead and install everything into the cap, install this, install the screw and everything, and how to bleed it. So let's get started here. And again, we're going to show you using the shocks here off of the 22 SCT. We're just in the middle of finishing up our build here, but this would work for any of the 22 based vehicles. So here we have our front shock for the 22 SCT. You can tell that because it has SCT front on the front of it. So for this shock, I'm going to go ahead and fill it with 100% genuine silicone shock oil here, and I'm actually going to use 32.5 weight for this. I'm going to take my oil, pour it in. Now for the rear, I'll actually go and use 27.5 weight. Now I don't want to fill it quite all the way up, but you can see about where I have it filled to. I'm going to move the piston up and down in a few times, and you're going to see some bubbles come out. This is perfectly normal. I'm going to add just a little bit more oil. If you spill some, that's okay. Just keep some paper towels handy to wipe that up. Now I'm going to go and set this shock aside, and that'll give it some time for the air bubbles to kind of come out. Now while I'm doing this one, I can go and do the other shock. So again, just kind of angle it and fill it and work the piston up and down a couple of times again. Now I don't know if you can make it out real well or not, but one tip I also have, is, if you look at the piston, I've taken a silver permanent marker and marked what number of the piston that this is. These are the stock pistons, so for the front, it's a 57, and then for a rear, it's a 55. So I'm gonna draw that back down. Again, you can kind of see how the whole oil just sucks down as I draw the piston down. And add just a little bit more here. And I am good on that. At this point, I'm going to grab my new O-ring that will go between the shock body and the cap. I'm going to set it on top. And I'm going to thread the body on. Now, unlike with the stock configuration, I can actually go and tighten this down completely. Now, one of the things that will make this a whole lot more useful and easier to do is Team Losi Racing's aluminum shock tools. It allows me to get a really good bite on the shock body and the cap as I go and tighten everything down. So here I have the aluminum top of the tool and the bottom. Just going to hold this, tighten it down the rest of the way. And there's that. And just so that I can do both of them at the same time, I'm going to put the second cap on here and get the other shock ready to go. Now, if you'd prefer, there's absolutely nothing wrong with putting the O-ring on the inside of the cap and then installing it onto the shock. So we'll do this one that way. To make sure you don't cross-thread the cap onto the shock, what I like to do, rotate it backwards a couple of turns. You'll kind of feel the threads seat properly. There, it just clicked, and now I can go and tighten everything down. And again, grab my shock tools. Now the 22, 22T, and 22 SCT all include molded plastic shock tools. These will just last longer. So now I have both my shocks ready to bleed. Before I do so, what I need to do is grab the screw, and there's a small copper washer that will go between the screw and the shock cap itself. This is what's actually helping provide the seal too. Now, I've seen some people who have done this and they've used threadlock on these screws. Normally for a metal-to-metal fastener, that's what you would want to do. That is not the case with these. You do not want to threadlock these on. You also need to make sure that you have this washer installed. You cannot have a proper shock assembly if you don't have this installed. Now the screw size on here is a 1.5 millimeter. Thought for a second it was an 050, but it's actually 1.5. So we have our 1.5 millimeter Allen wrench here. And what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna set this aside for right now. I'm gonna take the shock, I'm gonna pull the piston all the way down and run it up. Now while I'm running the piston up, you can see some oil come weeping out of the cap, that's normal. And I also want to make sure that the cap stays vertical, basically, so that the hole is straight up and down. At this point, I take my screw, thread it on in there. Draw the piston out. Make sure that there's no air in there. And we're sealed up and ready to go. At this point, what I can do is I can install my spring on here, my spring perch, and this is ready to install on the truck. We're going to do the other one the exact same way. Now, you may notice that your piston and shock end may be pulled up a little bit into the shock body. This is normal, but you don't want this to be extreme or excessive. You want just a little bit of that going on. The best way to do it and the most consistent handling you'll get is if you build them what's called dead, where it doesn't draw out at all. The hard part about that is making sure that you don't have excess air in the chamber. So we're going to go ahead and push that up. You see again some oil come weeping out. put the screw on. At this point, I'm going to draw the piston down. I'm going to hold it in place, remove the screw, and by removing the screw, I'm also relieving the pressure, and reinstall the screw, run it through its range of motion, and now you see here, I'm getting some rebound out of it. I don't want that. So I'm going to pull the screw out again, and it may take once or twice of you running everything down to have that built properly. So there's that. Thread it back in. Pull a shock down. Pull a screw out to relieve the pressure. And this is about the easiest way to make sure that you build your shocks dead, like I mentioned. And now we have it. You can see the shock has got just very little rebound to it, which is normal. And it goes through its range of motion without any air in the cylinder. Before we install these on the front end of our truck, the last thing we're going to do is we're going to actually match our shocks. And we're going to do that by using the shock matching tool. It's really simple to use. I've already got part of it assembled on here, part of it on the shocks. All I need to do is install the upper shock cap eyelets, basically, or the bushings, into the caps on each of the shocks. Thread that onto here, and then put the lower eyelet onto the lower mount. There we go there. And now I can install the other one on the other side. And this does a lot of different things for me. First of all, if I stretch this all the way, it tells me whether or not my shocks are the same length. And basically what I'm looking at is this needle pointer there. I want it to be straight down and lined up with the basically the center point that we have on there. Looking at it, it looks like this shock might be a hair long, and I can go ahead and I can shorten up this by probably a turn that would even me out. The other thing I can do is by squeezing it down, it'll kind of give me an indication whether or not I have equal oil in both shocks. So let's give her a squeeze down. And there, it looks like it's pretty well balanced from one side to the other. The other thing that it can do is tell me whether or not I've got the same shock oil in one shock versus the other. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to simulate like this has too much oil in it. And by that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to push down here. So what that's telling me is this is only able to compress that far. The other one compressed all the way. So, quick and easy way to go and test to see if your shocks are balanced left to right. So there you have it, how to install the bleeder caps on the Team Losi Racing shocks for the 22, 22T, and 22 SCT, along with how to go and use the shock matching tool on here. Really simple to use, and go out and make sure that you get the most consistent shock performance time after time. And again, these are compatible with the shocks on the 22, both the race kit and the ready-to-run version, the 22T, again the ready-to-run and the kit, and the 22 SCT. They're actually included as stock components on the 22 SCT. If you do have any comments or questions about anything that you've seen here today, or anything RC in general, please feel free to email us at editors@horizonrc.com. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.